room. I mean, this is amazing. I have to say thank you to Pat Hickey and the CSAN board for organizing this great opportunity to talk to you. And I hope all of you know this, but I'm going to say it anyways. Pat, 20 years ago this year, you passed legislation to get charter schools started in Nevada. 20 years ago. Instructional model, via choice, personal learning, expeditionary learning, living history days, authentic informative and summative assessments. We have innovation and leveraging technology, and we do not believe in failure. Instead, we believe in iterations. Everything is about iterations. We have promote healthy habits, and we have global leadership opportunities for our students and educators. We have excellence in educators, and we have leadership in systems thinking, family engagement, and community engagement in our small school community. At SNACS, we strive for deeper personalized learning for students, parents, and educators. But there's something more, there's something bigger than all of us. It's about our collective power. SNACS Small School Community for Personalized Learning is about building relationships, as Katie mentioned. It takes time and investment in expecting the highest of standards while acknowledging areas for growth and struggles. It's about supporting engaging systems, students towards building tenacity, grit, and perseverance. Instilling a belief system that they belong and they're empowered to make decisions every day toward their own college and career readiness. When we were creating the video, I asked the group of third graders that were featured in the video, and they self-selected to be part of that panel. They raised their hand. They wanted to be part of that leadership role. And I just happened to ask them during the interview, how many of you are going to go to college? And instantly, every single hand went up, without a doubt. Doesn't matter where they come from, what their background is, every single hand in third grade, they're ready for college. Students know that they have a voice and a choice in their education. It's about bridging gaps and helping families get the resources they need to thrive within the community. This hard work is not for everyone. It involves knowing oneself and being able to give up oneself for the greater commitment and vision of what's good for the whole community. Beyond traditional walls, we have historically called schooling. I know some of you can relate to this, many of you can relate to this, but it's about being there with families at birthdays, baseball games, sports meets, kin sierras, births, christenings, bar mitzvahs, dedications, finding health resources and access to medical care. It's about supporting family members through sicknesses and surgeries and sometimes even cancer. It's about paying tribute as a parent leaves in service of our country or thankfully celebrating when they return home. It's about standing between two rival gang members, requiring them to stand down at a kindergarten graduation because our students deserve unity, peace, and celebration. True story. It's about driving across town to give a student a ride because they've been placed in a group home and they wouldn't be able to attend otherwise because the state could not afford to provide transportation to them. And that's our education director who did that every day last year for a year to ensure a student got to stay at the school that they knew since they were little. It's about planning and attending weddings. It's about holding a family while a mother shares the tragic news of her father's death, of their father's death. It's about being in a place where a runaway seeks help when they're lost, even when they don't attend the school anymore, but they know they can come to us. It's about finding a runaway who wants to be lost and encouraging them not to. It's about talking and visiting former students who, for unfortunate circumstances, ended up incarcerated, but you want to see them overcome and know that mistakes happen and you have hope for the future. You believe in them, because once a student, always a student. It's about planning a funeral for an alumni student because the parents are too broken to plan. And I saw our staff do that last year. That's commitment. It goes beyond the walls that we have for education and schooling. It's about being committed and sometimes facing an inconvenient truth. It's about being relentless and advocating for our kids because one caring teacher can teach them about grit and perseverance and that they can overcome and we can mitigate the obstacles that they're faced with every day. We can help them be college and career ready. It's about knowing who you are as a leader and what your purpose is in this world and to share that purpose with others. It's to stand up for what's right, regardless of what the cost. It's about forging out against the status quo and challenging others to do the same. It's about leading a movement that is unstoppable because our children and our families deserve this. It's about leading others in all things, education, child development, and innovation. So I encourage you, fellow innovators, thinkers, dreamers, creators, tinkermakers, and status quo shakers in this room, please join me in the spirit of SNACS and Nevada Charter Schools to carry that spirit torch, hold it high and proud, because we are leading education and innovation.